You may know of Greta Thunberg, the Swedish teenager who's galvanizing the global movement demanding action on climate change. She, as a founder of School Drive for Climate Action, she is a voice for her generation and a voice for the planet. But what about all those people behind her? Who are they? What brought them here? What do they hope to achieve and are they achieving it? These are the questions my PhD research has been. Now, the environmental movement is a highly complex and dynamic system, so I use digital humanities tools to capture big data to inform my findings. For example, I analysed over 60,000 web pages from environmental groups to ask the question, who are Australian environmental activists? And I found that they're people just like us. People from all backgrounds, all ages, all walks of life, coming together in thousands of little groups active right across Australia. And you might know of some of these groups like Greenpeace and Friends of the Earth, but the vast majority are grassroots, people taking action in their local communities almost entirely as volunteers. So the movement is far larger and more diverse than we realised before. But why do they do it? Well, the research on the social psychology of collective action points to factors known to motivate people to engage in activism. Like, for example, a feeling of anger or outrage really helps. But when I'm taught to long-term activists, I found something else. It was often the joy of friendship and the pride of being part of a group trying to make the world a better place, which is what motivated those people to continue their efforts year after year after year. And that's significant because without those people, activism like that doesn't happen. But is it successful? To answer this, I tracked 58 Australian climate change campaigns over a two-year period. Some of these campaigns wanted to stop new coal mines. Some of them wanted government to enact new climate policy. Of course, these campaigns are only a small part of the solution we need for climate change. But even so, almost half, partially or fully, achieved their aims. Coal mines were delayed. Climate policy was enacted. And in particular, 63% of campaigns asking businesses to reduce their climate impact were successful. Now, the scale of the environmental crisis we face is confronting, and it is felt to feel despair. But my research using real-world data shows that we can make fast and meaningful change by harnessing the power of all those people, the army of people who walk with Greta. Environmental activism does succeed. We just need more of it. Thank you.